But at that time, I wasn't ready to deal with the fact that I was an alcoholic. I thought AA was a joke, and I was just basically going there for my friends. So I can, you know, like my friends were like extremely busy even recovering from alcoholism, and the only way I could see them was to attend the meeting. So I pretended, yeah, I realize I'm an alcoholic. Mm-hmm. But I never really did, because I can go, like, if I'm not triggered, I can go without drinking for like a very, very long time. So, and plus, when I really started drinking, when I started working for my godmom and we really started drinking, we were drinking cocktails. Mm-hmm. And it's like extremely convenient to lie to yourself and to say, well, I can't be an alcoholic. I am just drinking cocktails. I'm not drinking vodka. I'm not drinking bourbon. I'm drinking cocktails. I'm a lady who's drinking cocktails with her godmother. And it took me a long time to actually realize that God was trying to tell me that I'm an alcoholic. A friend of mine, Bevan Love, she works for Heart and Soul. She's the head of Seeing Through Stigma. And she came, I already lost the apartment, and I was at Hawthorn House in Redwood City, and she came with her presenters, and that was the time when the Warriors were going for the championship, and we were like, oh lady, come on, like just say whatever you have to say and just get out, we want to watch the championship. And then she says something, then Bevan says that her mother was her drinking partner, and I'm like, wait a minute, my godmother was my drinking partner. And I'm like, whoa, maybe you should forget about, like I know it was God speaking through me, like kind of like, just forget about the championship, just talk to this lady. And we started talking, and then I ended up working for her. I ended up doing presentations of my own, and I'm still doing the presentations of my own, but that's the way I realized that I had a serious problem. Mm.